السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. My brothers and sisters, Eid Mubarak to you all. ما شاء الله تبارك الله. Here in Zimbabwe, it's already almost the time of Salatul Isha, and tomorrow morning we will be gathering and we will be, just as a small family, we will be practicing whatever we can in terms of precautions, but we will still be having a small Eid Salah. And we will still be celebrating, we will still be sacrificing, and perhaps I may show you a little bit of what we might be doing tomorrow on a live session, perhaps from where I will be with the lambs and the sheep and the goats and so on. So, my brothers and sisters, is it fair for me to be happy on the day of sacrifice when I have sacrificed nothing for Allah? People are so proud of having sinned against Allah. People are so proud of having removed their own, subhanAllah, obedience of Allah. And they announce it proudly, publicly, to say, hey guys, look what I've done. I'm actually no more praying from today. And I'm no more eating halal food from today. And I'm going to be having some pork and alcohol from today. And then they say, Eid Mubarak, guys, it's the day of Eid. Let's be happy. Be happy for what? Ouch. Ouch. For what? Allah just replaced you with someone else, because you decided to openly publicize your sins. To commit adultery is sinful, but to announce it is way, way more sinful. The hadith of the Prophet ﷺ says people will remain within hope, within goodness, for as long as they don't openly commit sin and they're not proud of it. So what is the sacrifice all about? Think. Allah instructed Ibrahim alayhi salam to do something. He said, Sami'na wa ata'na. I've done it. And subhanAllah, here goes. Allah says, you deserve a day of Eid and everyone's going to have to follow suit. But what about us? When Allah told us to do something, we're doing the opposite and we're saying, Eid Mubarak, I'm so happy. We have this Eid. We have this Eid. By the way, some of you are saying that Eid is on a Saturday. No problem. For those whose Eid is on Saturday, We're happy for you as well, mashallah. But this message is, do you know Allah says, when you turn away, Allah replaces you with others who will not be like you. So when a person obeys Allah's instruction, they deserve this Eid. It is the Eid of sacrifice. Have you sacrificed something? Allah instructed you to do something and you did it, whether you liked it or not, whether it made sense to you or not, then you deserve this Eid. That's what this Eid is all about, the Eid of submission, the Eid of obedience, the Eid of doing that, whether it made sense to you or it didn't make sense to you. Here is the Eid, subhanAllah. So Ibrahim alayhi salam was told to sacrifice his son. Did it make sense to him? No, zero sense. But what happened? He knew it was from Allah and Allah would never instruct him to do something detrimental for him. There must be something powerful about this. So what did he do? Subhanallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, as he was going to obey our instruction, we replaced his son with a ram and we made it a sunnah. We became pleased with him. And that is the day of Eid. It's called Yawm al-Nahr, the day of spilling. Subhanallah, the sacrificial animal's blood. And subhanallah, for you and I, what's more important is the sacrifice. What are you prepared? When Allah told you, do your salah, are you ready to sacrifice your bed? Are you going to put the knife on the bed to make sure I'm up for Fajr? If that's the case, you deserve this Eid. It's the Eid for sacrifice. When Allah told you to dress in a specific way, have you dressed that way? Even if maybe it might have been, shaitan might have tried to beautify the other way for you, but you knew that's the beautification of shaitan. This is the beautification of Allah. I need to do this. Let me do this. Is that what you have done? If you have obeyed Allah at a time when it was so difficult, that is when you can say Eid Mubarak and enjoy the Eid and this day of the sacrifice. What's the point of sacrificing? And this is the reason why some people say, we're not going to sacrifice. I've got a cabbage in my garden and I'm going to give that cabbage because, you know, I don't believe in this sacrifice. Subhanallah. Remember, my brothers and sisters, this Eid is all about sacrificing for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So if you are going to sacrifice, alhamdulillah, I want to highlight a point. There are some people who actually say, you know, I no longer believe in what Allah said. Oh, I'm not going to do this anymore. Some say, well, I believe in it, but I don't want to do it anymore. My sister, my brother, no need to announce that. You don't have to announce it to the public that I'm weak, because by you making a public announcement of your disobedience of Allah, you're actually doing something more wrong than your own weakness. If it's your own weakness, keep it to yourself. But if you're going to come out and announce it, you know what it is? It's like Allah telling Ibrahim alayhi salam, we want you to sacrifice. Here's the knife and here's the thing. And you throw the knife back at Allah and you tell the whole world, I threw the knife back at Allah. That's what I did. And I threw this, you know, I'm not going to even, he replaced it with a ram. I'm throwing the ram back at him. And I'm throwing this, and guys, that's who I am. This is who I am. I am a person who will never, ever do what this instruction. Why are you making such an announcement, my brother, my sister? No need to do that, subhanAllah. If you have a weakness, yes, by all means, you're a human. You may have struggles we don't know about. But when you announce it, it becomes terrible. And you know what happens? Happens after that? We become people who actually are carriers of evil, where we are promoting vice, even if we were to come back one day. And this is what I'm saying, brothers and sisters, let's come back to Allah. Allah's giving us a chance. The day of Arafah, the day of Eid, the day of Nahr. What's the lesson? Wallahi, the lesson is not the meat. The lesson is not the blood. The lesson is not even the sacrificial animal. لَنْ يَنَالَ اللَّهَ لُحُومُهَا وَلَا دِمَاؤُهَا وَلَكِنْ يَنَالُهُ التَّقْوَى مِنْكُمْ. Allah says, the meat is not going to get to us. The blood is not going to get to us. The taqwa, the relationship you developed with Allah as a result, is what is going to get to us. Have you developed taqwa? Have you developed the consciousness of Allah? Someone is saying, I'm looking weak, subhanAllah. Perhaps it's the lighting, and perhaps it's me. I've been all day, mashallah, with different programs and different things, subhanAllah. But my brothers and sisters, we don't deserve the Eid the way we carry on. We've sacrificed nothing for Allah. It's not about the meat. It's not about, you know, buying expensive animals. It's about how I dress, how I talk, what I do. Have I fulfilled my duties, my 5 daily prayers? Have I given charities? Have I been kind to people? Have I dressed appropriately? Have I spoken to people with a high level of morality and with high values and so on? If that's the case, and I'm making sure that I can obey the instruction of Allah to, you know, to whether it suits my whims and fancies or not, then I deserve the sacrifice. Wallahi, in that case, even if you were in quarantine, you deserve this day of Eid. Allah will give you reason to rejoice. He will declare you a friend of mine. When Ibrahim alayhi salam was tested, he passed the test. He went out to do something that did not make sense to him, because he knew Allah instructed him, and he tried it out. When he did it, Allah says, you are our friend. اتخذ الله إبراهيم خليلا. Allah says, you have passed the test. Allah says, that was the إِنَّ هَذَا لَهُوَ الْبَلَاءُ الْمُبِينُ. This was indeed a clear-cut, major, massive test. Brothers and sisters, we cannot even give up pornography. Eid Mubarak. We cannot even fulfill 5 salah. Eid Mubarak. Eid Mubarak. What's it all about? We cannot even give up immorality and evil. Eid Mubarak. Yeah? We cannot even dress a little bit appropriately. Eid Mubarak. Eid Mubarak. We are so engrossed in haram, completely left to right, center. This is the day of sacrifice. Come on. Come on. We cannot control ourselves when it comes to our phones. Eid Mubarak. Do you really think that's what this day of sacrifice is all about? Sacrifice that porn, put a knife on it. Sacrifice your bad habits, put a knife on it. Sacrifice the adultery, put a knife on it. Sacrifice all the evil, put a knife on it. Become strong with your worship. Advertise your obedience, but do not advertise your disobedience. Remember that. Advertise your obedience, do not advertise your disobedience. If you advertise your obedience, you will get reward even the day you happen to privately become weak and sin. But you will come back to Allah. Allah will reward you for all of those who practiced as a result of you advertising obedience, meaning encouraging people to be obedient. But when you advertise your sin, even if you quit the sin and you engage in tawbah and you turn back to Allah, trust me, you are going to earn such a sin for all of those who practiced your bad example. My brothers, my sisters, it is definitely not worth It is not worth advertising your disobedience. You are challenging Rabbul Alameen. You are challenging the Lord of the worlds. Do you know the coronavirus that has actually attacked the entire globe? The weight of it in terms of grammage is less than 1 gram that is on earth right now. And it has shaken all of us up. If that hasn't made us think about Allah and made us become better people, because we don't know how long we're going to live for. My brothers and sisters, how are we going to ever turn back to Allah? You know, people are defying Allah. They are proud about going against the law of Allah, and they call themselves Muslims. That's what it is. Don't do that. This is the day of sacrifice. Inshallah, you can obey Allah. And my brothers and sisters, the only reason I'm saying this is because I truly love you, and I truly would like Jannah for me and for you. And I truly want you to think about it. When you're doing a good thing, you can advertise it. When you're doing a bad thing, keep it private. Keep it within yourself. No need to advertise. You know what? No need to talk about it and encourage others to follow your sin. Whether you're drinking, whether you're on drugs, whether you're, you know, whether you're... for example, have bad habits, whether you've just abandoned your hijab, whether you've just abandoned your fajr and dhuhr, whether you've abandoned the recitation of the Quran, whatever it is, do not ever, ever advertise your sins, because by that you would be promoting it in one way or another. You would be giving courage to others to do the same as you, and you actually did not do the right thing. So what was the point of advertising it and saying, well, I'm empowering myself and I'm empowering others? Empower people when it comes to the obedience of Allah. That is what the sacrifice of Ibrahim alayhi salam actually is. So I want to say to all of us, Eid Mubarak. May Allah bless you guys and have a blessed Eid. And may Allah grant you every goodness and open your doors. This short session where I decided to talk about who actually deserves this Eid is mainly because I felt it necessary to remind those I love. I'm normally a very calm person. I normally speak with a very loving way. I don't judge people as best as I can. I stay away from that. But to be honest with you, I have to say, my brothers and sisters, sometimes we need to say it as it is and tell you, you know what? If you think you deserve the Eid and Eid Mubarak and everything here, what have you sacrificed? Are you ready to admit in your life, what was it that you're struggling with in terms of obedience of Allah or disobedience of Allah? What is it that's holding you back? Cut it. Then you can say, Eid Mubarak, Eid Mubarak, Eid Mubarak, guys, mashallah. And then you deserve it. May Allah bless you all. Jazakumullah khair. Thank you for listening. Love you guys. Have a beautiful Eid. Whether you're having Eid today, tomorrow, or the following day, please have a lovely Eid. Love you guys. And inshallah, we meet again with much, much love. Just a quick point before I go. I'm not aiming my talk at anyone in particular. I'm aiming it at myself to begin with. And then all of us together, we must learn to obey the instruction of Allah. Be happy and be pleased with this beautiful, beautiful instruction of Allah, where He says, you know what, if you're weak and you're sinning, we know that you're human, you may sin. Don't do it in public. Don't be proud about it. Don't announce it. Don't advertise it. But where you want to encourage others to do good and you've done a little bit of good, you may well encourage them by talking about it. And wa amma bi ni'mati rabbika fahaddith. Allah has blessed us in so many ways. Thank you so much. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.